Are you concerned about the volatility in the financial markets today? Do you think something needs to be done to reduce it?
I love volatility. I think I remember when in 1972 the market went from down dramatically, and Taco Bell went from 14 to 1. They had no debt. They never had a restaurant close. And I started buying at 7, but I kept on to it, and it went to 1. And it was the largest position in Magellan in 1978, when it was bought out by $42 by Pepsi-Cola. And I think it would have gone to 400 if they didn't buy it out. I think volatility is terrific. I think it is very, I think these callers are very important. I don't think the market going up 80 points one day and down 80 the next is a good thing for the public. I think that's not a very good thing. But I think all of these callers and all these other things, to keep the volatility down each day is important. But the market's going to go up and down. Human nature hasn't changed a lot in 25,000 years. And some event will come out of left field, and the market will go down or the market will go up. So volatility will occur, and markets will continue to have these ups and downs. I think that's a great opportunity if people can understand what they own. If they don't understand what they own, they can own mutual funds, try and figure out mutual funds they own, and keep adding to it. Over, basic corporate profits have grown about 8% a year historically. So corporate profits double about every 9 years. The stock market ought to double about every 9 years. So I think the next market's about 3,800 today, 3,700. I'm pretty convinced the next 3,800 points will be up. It won't be down. The next 500 points, the next 600 points, I don't know which way they're going. So the market ought to double in the next 8 or 9 years. It ought to double again in the 8 or 9 years after that. Because profits will go up 8% a year, and stocks will fall. That's all there is to it. But you should study history, and history is the important thing you learn from. What you learn from history is the market goes down. It goes down a lot. The math is simple. There's been 93 years a century. This is easy to do. The market's had 50 declines of 10% or more. So 50 declines in 93 years. About once every 2 years, the market falls 10%. We call that a correction. That means, that's a euphemism for losing a lot of money rapidly. But we, you know, we call it a correction. And so 50 declines in 93 years, about once every 2 years, the market falls 10%. Of those 50 declines, 15 have been 25% or more. That's known as a bear market. We've had 15 declines in 93 years. So every 6 years, the market's going to have a 25% decline. That's all you need to know. You need to know the market's going to go down sometime. If you're not ready for that, you shouldn't own stocks. And it's good when it happens. If you like a stock at 14 and it goes to 6, that's great. You understand the company, you look at the balance sheet, and they're doing fine, and you're hoping to get to 22 with it. 14 to 22 is terrific. 6 to 22 is exceptional. So you take advantage of these declines. They're going to happen. No one knows when they're going to happen. It would be very, people tell you about it after the fact that they predicted it, but they predicted it 53 times. And so you can take advantage of the volatility in the market if you understand what you own.